Welcome and thank you for joining me. I'm Jerry Ojinski, a New York medical malpractice and personal injury trial attorney practicing law here in the state of New York. Let's see. No, I'm cutting off my head. I'm going to zoom out and continue. All right, we're continuing a series of video tips that talks about definitions of things that you commonly hear in lawsuits in New York. Well, what's the next one we're up to? The next definition we get to is something you hear all the time on TV. Objection sustained. Well, you hear it at trial mostly. When an attorney is asking a witness a question, the defense will stand up and say, "Judge, objection." And by the way, attorneys always have to stand up when they object because it's a rule of decorum. You show the court respect by standing up and objecting. Plus, everybody gets to hear you. It's a nice big show. They look at a diversion. It's something different. It breaks things up. So when a judge says objection sustained, it means that the witness is not allowed to answer the question. Why not? Well, there may be a legal issue that the judge does not want to put in front of the jury, and so they don't want the witness answering it. From a legal standpoint, the court has to make an instant snap decision about whether the witness can or cannot answer. So let's turn it around now. I ask the witness a question, and I hear from the defense, objection! The judge thinks that the witness should be allowed to answer it, so the judge will say, objection overruled. Go ahead and answer the question. We now have objection sustained and objection overruled about whether a witness can or cannot answer the question. And why else do attorneys make objections during trial? Two reasons. One, to create a diversion, if nothing else. Two, they have to protect the record, meaning that they have to protect their client's rights, because if they don't object to a particular problem that they believe is occurring at the time of trial, if the case goes up on appeal, they will lose the ability to argue that point if they don't raise a valid objection during the course of trial. So if the defense attorney is sleeping during a point when an objection should be made, and they lose the case, and now they bring an appeal, and they want to argue that the reason they lost the case is because of the point that the witness was talking about at that moment. Guess what? The defense will lose because he should have raised it at the time of trial. And the attorney's failure to bring up that objection at the right time means that he has waived that objection. So it's very deadly for an attorney if they do not raise the objection. That's why you'll see attorneys jumping up all the time, raising an objection. Objection, sustained. Objection, overruled. It's almost comical when you think about it, but it's a very significant point for an attorney to make during the course of trial in protecting their client's interests. I hope these definitions of basic terms that you've heard me talking about have been helpful to educating you about lawsuits here in the state of New York and how cases work. And if you have more legal questions about medical malpractice or accident cases here in New York, I encourage you to pick up the phone and call me. I can answer your legal questions. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at lawmed10@yahoo.com. I'm Jerry Ojinski. I want to thank you for joining me here. Have a great day.